welcome to a very special Steven and Tyler Rock Show today, where we are unbelievably excited to welcome Mike Ness and Johnny Two Bags Wickersham from Social Distortion. This is huge for us that you guys are here. We're just very psyched.
Thanks
and
for having us.
Huge fans. We're going to talk to them. And first, we've got a couple of videos for you to check out, starting with Dropkick Murphys' Sunshine Highway. There's another one of our faves, The Bronx with False Alarm. And here with Social Distortion. You guys played New York City, four nights in New York City. And you gave the fans a treat. The show I went to, you played a brand new song, Diamond in the Rough. You know, what's that song about? And are you doing a new record?
Well, we would like to do a new record soon. It won't be 8 years, definitely, till our next one. We had a great experience making this last record. And we have a lot of songs for a new record. So, I mean, I can't say it'll be next year, but I think we'll probably be, it would be nice to be in the studio at the end of next year. So
it's not going to be 8 years. Why so long between White Light, White Heat and Sex, Love, and Rock and Roll?
Wish I could tell you. You know, it was just life, you know, doing life's stuff. I went and did the solo stuff for a couple of years, mm-hmm. and that took time, and then when I thought it was time to make a record, then we had a death in the band. So, you know, it's just life happens sometimes.
When you decided to do the solo stuff, was that because you just wanted to kind of get away from the band atmosphere?
Yeah, I really don't like these guys, so I mean, I had to just get away from them for a while.
I've seen them.
No, I mean, it was a personal thing. I wanted to show people that I could do other things. To myself, more importantly, that, you know, I always brought these elements of root music to Social Distortion, but felt that I could also only go so far.
Right.
And this enabled me to cross all those lines and not have, you know, these, like, you know, punk rock school or restrictions, which are ridiculous anyways. But,
right.
And not that we pay attention to it, but,
no.
You know.
Yeah, not many punk rock bands are going to throw out Johnny Cash, so these guys do it. Well, they should. All right, it's time to submit to our ad sales department. We'll be back more with Social D and many, many more videos in about 4 minutes-ish.
The news and musings of the SURS world by visiting the Untitled Rock blog through the link at fuse.tv/Steven.
Hey, welcome back to today's show, and welcome once again to Mike and Johnny from Social Distortion. We touched briefly on your solo work. How different is the writing process solo than working with Social Distortion?
Not much difference. I mean, it's basically you get ideas, and you know, I still have just a little tape recorder, you know, a little ghetto box, and just write down ideas, and then bring it down to the band, and we try it, you know, and if we like it, we keep it. And, but I mean, obviously, you know, there's, and I'm always writing for both, but I mean, there's some songs that are, I'm writing, well, this is definitely, you know, something that is more of a solo feel, or this is definitely Social D. I mean, but sometimes it's hard to decipher.
You have certain songs you're just like, maybe it's more just me, maybe I won't take this to the band.
It's hard to decide which one to be selfish with, you know, because I love them both. I mean, I love the solo stuff, and I love Social Distortion. So it's kind of dealing with like maybe multiple personalities or something. I don't know.
So you just gotta flip a coin. All right. Do you ever get writer's block?
Yeah. I mean, I found that if you get out of practice, you know, if you're not, if you stop writing for a while and try to pick it back up, it's really, you know, it's just like anything, you go and try and shoot baskets,
right.
You know, and you haven't shot in a long time, it's just like you're horrible, you know, it's like, this is crap, you know, this is just, and
you got to get back in the swing of it.
You got to get back in the swing, and I think that it's good, though, to write crap and see that it's crap. And I like seeing a wastebasket, you know, full of crumbled up paper, because that just tells me that it makes me feel like I'm working and that I'm challenging myself.
You know the good when you got the crap. And here's a band that's not crap. This is a favorite of all of us here. This is The Explosion with No Revolution. We love them, you love them. The Explosion with No Revolution. It's time for another break. We got more Hang Time in store with Social Distortion, plus another half dozen videos. So why would you leave? Hey, welcome back. We got Mike and Gianni, two bags from Social Distortion on the couch today, and we'll do some more catching up after you check out some more music. Here is Armor for Sleep with Car Underwater. That's Bleed the Dream with Just Like I Remember. Now, that was produced by Cameron Webb, as was the record Sex, Love, and Rock and Roll. Right here, it took us a while to get out. How'd you get hooked up with him, and how was the process?
Where did we meet him? I don't remember.
Somewhere in Orange County. Someone brought him around the studio.
Yeah, just a local guy, and, you know, not afraid to challenge us, you know, and it's just... but respects, you know, our signature sound and you know, just try to get tradition with a little bit of a contemporary edge, you know. I think we achieved it.
You got a co-producing credit on the record. Have you always been co-producing? Do you like producing more?
I've been there for every single hands-on. So for the mixing, for everything, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, do you like that? Do you like button heads with the producer, or do you like to, are you always more in control?
I like button heads with anybody, but no. I do. I mean, you know, I've just found that I like working in the studio just as much as I like being on a stage. You know, not as much applause,
right,
but there's just as much satisfaction, yeah.
Now, in between White Light, White Heat and Sex, Love, and Rock and Roll, you did have a death in the band, and you wrote the song Don't Take Me for Granted. How therapeutic is songwriting for you?
Well, it's very necessary, I think. I'm not the best communicator, you know, when it comes to real feelings and stuff like that, so music enables me to do that.
That's really good.
And writing that song was both one of the easiest songs to write and one of the hardest songs to write, because it was hard to make it through it, mm-hmm, without feeling all those emotions, obviously, but it was also easy to just close my eyes and get about four or five visuals of him and I growing up. And then the next thing you know, the song was done. You know.
That's great. It's really cool to hear when you play it. It's time for sponsors to take control again, but we're only halfway through today's show, so stay tuned for more chat with Social D, plus our classic from the day, which is Social Distortion. Go figure. It's not to be vain. Welcome back to our Social Distortion edition of SURS. We're going to ask right now, since you've been around, what do you think of the punk scene today? What's right or wrong with it?
Is there a punk scene today?
It's a question we talk about a lot here, and because we've got bands floating in who are, you know, 16 and, mm-hmm, to the old elder statesman, I guess. It's weird. Even on the Warped Tour.
Where's an elder statesman?
I have no idea. I thought we brought one in from Milwaukee, but...
I think there's good music coming out now, and there's, as always, a lot of bad stuff. I mean, the difference, I think... The most obvious difference for me anyways, is when we started our band, we were part of a revolution that was periodical. I mean, it was a part of that period. It was the late 70s. We were very unhappy with what was happening musically, politically, just the mainstream ideals. And I believe that, we set out to change things, and we have. I mean, now this music is a major format. It's acknowledged now. It's, where before it was considered insignificant, now, you know, people stop and listen. So I believe, you know, that we've opened society's minds. But it's just like everything. I mean, if I turn on, you know, country music channel right now, and I watch a contemporary country artist, it's the same thing as in the early 80s when I turned on the TV and, you know, what was being played on then. Now I wanted to kick in the television set. You know, it gets a lot can get lost in translation.
Right.
You have misinterpretations.
Right.
You have, you know, it can be homogenized by the industry, by record labels, by...
It's kind of weird when the, we gotta go to a video, but it's kind of weird when the revolution becomes the norm, you know. Here's a band that was kind of revolutionary when they were on our couch. Here's the Dillinger Escape Plan with Unretrified. That's the DEP with Unretrified. We're gonna be right back with more Social Distortion, both in person and on video. Welcome back to Surge with Mike and Johnny from Social Distortion. We're gonna chat with a few moments, but first, here's Emmanuel with The Willing. A DVD called Another State of Mind, which has been floating around forever on video, and you might not know it, you need to know it, and you guys, you put it on DVD. How'd you get it back?
We made them an offer they couldn't refuse.
With a bat?
We got it back and reissued it and put a commentary to it, so it's a tragic comedy that everyone should see.
Yeah, it's wonderful. That's great. You should go out and get it. It's break time. Hold tight. We're going to be right back with Social D. All right, run out of time, so here's Against Me with Don't Lose Touch. That's it. Thanks so much. Like, thanks Social Distortion for, one, being here, and just for the music, for everything. Huge fans. Glad you guys are here. Check out Social Distortion on tour. Pick up their latest Sex, Love, and Rock and Roll. It's awesome. And now, this is the one. This is Ball and Chain, everybody. Social Distortion. Thank you, guys. You should forget me.